Alberto Crane. This is our first team trip.
Passenger
book. We're basically bringing all our instructors that you know that teach at our school and our staff, you know, to kind of experience you know the Jiu-Jitsu lifestyle in Brazil, the Mecca. You know, we have you know, our coach Donnie right here, Donnie Flowers, our manager George Bonilla, Rob Gooch, head instructor Gracie Barra Woodland Hills, Dan Blagic, runs Gracie Barra Encino, Rockley. Say what's up, Rockley. So I'm super pumped, can't wait, and yeah, let's get it going.
Black of peas came to make it hotter. We beat the fire starter. Bubbling up just like lava, heated like a sauna. Penetrating through your body armor. Rhythmically we massage ya. With hip hop mixed up with samba. What's up,
so yes. And we're gonna be here at my favorite spot, Bibi Sucos in Baja. And then we're gonna go training.
And we won't stop until we get y'all. Till we get y'all, say it.
Today, you know, but you know, we checked into our place and we're staying on the island where I used to live, Ilha de Jiguaya, you know, right down the street.
My name is Roberto Correa de Lima. People call me Gordo. And I started training 28 years ago. I meet him. I think Amal bring him to Brazil. Amal is another good friend. And he lived it.
Back in the mid-90s, I come here with Amal Easton, and you know, I meet Gordo here at the Gracie Barra, and he was one of the senior, you know, black belts back then. And he was always the guy that was at the tournaments helping us out, you know, mentoring us, and always being there for the tournaments. I didn't speak Portuguese at the time, and he didn't speak English at the time, but he was always there helping us.
Train a lot of jiu-jitsu. I always see him training hard, competing hard. These guys, American guys, who really train jiu-jitsu. He spent like more than 5 years, probably 7-8 years here, I'm out too. And really training, and he went back to US, come back here again, training in Belo Horizonte with Drapolino, and always training hard. His nickname is Gringuinho. He's like probably 150 that time, his weight, and he's small. But he give a hard time to us, and that's why he's tough, and he's black, good black belt. Like I said, world champion, former UFC.
Coming back here on his mats, like it feels so good. I feel like a family, you know, right away. As soon as I step on the mat, like I look at everybody, familiar faces, and I feel the warmth, and I'm so grateful to be here, and I'm so grateful for, you know, all he's done for me and for all the guys, all for Jiu-Jitsu. This man right here has influenced me so much, and you know, it just feels so good. Feels so good to be here. Thank you, Gordo. Thank you for having me.
Check it out.
What I like about Jiu-Jitsu,
you know, it challenges your mind and body at the same time, and I love that.
I was not talking to people, I was not smiling.
Because of the lifestyle.
You're in your own world when you're training.
It's become a part of my life. I feel a sense of self-worth that I haven't felt in a very long time.
It's a never-ending growth.
I became more social through Jiu-Jitsu.
You're not thinking about anything else. You know, if you have a bad day, none of that matters when you're training. You're just like in your own zone.
Amazing